already done that for you, but if you're going to manage the IDs. So all of these DIDs are currently routed. Oh, Mike, we're doing 10 digits to the thing itself. Carla, we're doing 11 digits.
These ones are all loaded as 11 digit.
And we loaded them in the Phoenix Soft as 11 digit.
They haven't been loaded yet into the Phoenix Soft.
Oh, so we have to load them. Okay, but we're sending them as 11 digit. Nathan.
Yeah. So I'm waiting for direction on that.
Okay, Nathan, do you use 10 digit, 11 digit, 7 digit, or 4 digit?
I think we use 10. Redo. Redo.
10?
Yeah, I Redo?
Yes.
Are we using 10 digits right now?
We are using 10 or 11, no problem. Can it be?
I find probably 10 is easiest. What do you think, Eric Levitt?
Well, I usually like to use 11 because we have customers that get DIDs from other countries.
Oh.
And then it becomes easier.
All right, so let's use 11. That's fine. Is that good, guys? 11?
Yeah. Okay. All right. So basically, then they're already routed. So basically, if you wanted to route this number, for example, you can just select it.
Okay.
It'll pull up the routing screen. You know, I may not be able to call you anymore. If your number's in this list, then oops. We probably have to route it out, but basically, once you select your number, you can also select multiple, but then you just say routed D. Now, right now, we have to insert those DIDs for you.
Okay.
We're working on a screen to make it easier, but basically, you can route to a gateway or route to PSTN. Like if I choose route to gateway, you'll choose the one. You've got the one gateway, so you select that. If you wanted to make a 10-digit. Basically, you would just select and then click submit and then confirm number.
Okay.
You have CLI rules, you can add ones, remove ones. So that depends on the incoming carrier. Like we can tend to just because 11 digits without pluses or E164, it's just give us the number and that's that country code plus number.
Okay.
I'm just using we but like Verizon, for example, if you had a direct connection with them, they put a plus in front of everything, which makes no sense. But you would just remove the plus on the way in. So this is to manipulate your CLI, and this is to manipulate your DNS. And basically, this is the primary gateway for the PhoenixSoft. The backup gateway is 250.70. The portal can't do that, so we do that for you in the background.
You do what in the background? Wait, Eric, what do you do in the background?
We set up the backup gateway at 250.70.
We won't see it, but it doesn't show on the screen.
You won't see it, but it's there.
Okay. Yeah.
It's there. Because the Phoenix Soft has two, clusters. For class 5, they don't run hot, they run primary standby.
Okay.
So you have a backup gateway as opposed to a load balance gateway.
All right, so is that all automated? We don't have to do anything if one goes down.
Yeah, deal with that. Yeah, that's our loading the DIDs is our problem, and we'll load them properly for you. So if you get a batch, then you just send it to us, and we'll load them for you. So they'll appear in your account here. You route them to the Phoenix. Well, normally what happens is we'll just route them for you to the Phoenix Soft, and that's that.
Okay.
And then you can remove routing if you don't want them to go anywhere, or you can route them directly out and bypass the Phoenix Soft. But that would be, I don't recommend you do that here because we were thinking about it internally and decided the best thing for you to do is actually get the CDRs off the Phoenix off.
Okay.
They have the response. So you want to go to the Phoenix off and then route it to the PSTN and Phoenix off, not through wholesale.
All right, so let me just see, can I just verify what we just said, first of all? So first of all, you built this front-end GUI. This front-end GUI is basically kind of a GUI that manages the Sansei session border controller, which then says to go to where to route everything, right?
Yeah, because when you're hosted class 5, if you're using us as a carrier, you're gonna have to send everything to us. So this is first point as carrier, and the route everything to the Phoenix Soft.
Right. So, And then if we want to add a DID, we're not able to do it ourselves, or we have to send it to you for the backup.
Not yet. We're adding a stream called translations, because they're not really, from our perspective, they're not technically DIDs.
Okay.
Because they're not in our footprint.
Okay.
So we're adding something called translations, and that's going to appear here, and then you'll be able to add your own numbers. Because the problem we've had in the past is we used to allow people to do that, mm-hmm. but then somebody got sued and decided to route 1-800-Flowers to their account and did it, because they had an outbound 800 deal, so they routed everything on our platform to them, and I was like, well, that's not right. So we have to, because the translations are sort of global, so we have to have protections in the background to make sure that they're really your numbers. So we're redesigning that interface.
Okay.
Yeah, so right now, if you want to add the IDs, you let us know, we'll add them. I mean, it's a simple process, do it right away. And then once they're in your interface, you can muck with them. But very soon, you'll be able to just add your own.
Okay.
Yeah, because we don't want people adding 1-700 numbers, you know, because we use 1-700 numbers inside the network. You know, we don't want people adding 800 numbers that aren't their own, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That sort of thing. And then for E911, you use this. So you would register an E911. You would register an E911 here, but we're not up to that step, so we're going to leave that alone for now. So that's all you have to do here. You know, if you actually want to order DIDs from us, you order them here.
Okay.
Let's say I want to say 5 DIDs, and I want them to be U.S. I want them to be in Jersey, and then I want them to be 201 numbers, and then I want them to be in whatever 800. So using the API, like let's say Jersey City, using the API, you could actually select the numbers from inventory. Using the web, you can't, but we're also working on that as well.
Okay.
Because virtually everybody that picks numbers actually does it via the API if they want them instantaneously.
Okay.
So you just place it here, and then you just click next, and it'll submit the order.
All right, so really, at this point in time, if I understand it correctly, in essence, we're not even going to be using this screen today, because everything we're going to do, we have to give you the phone numbers that we already have with VoIP Innovation.
Generally speaking, right now, just email us the orders. The people that use this are usually the people that kind of hate human beings and really just want to do everything on their own.
Okay.
But we're actually working on allowing them to get the
idea. All right, well, I'm just from a training process, because I got 4 of my guys here. So from a training...
Now just email us when you need.
All right, but so it doesn't even seem like, correct me if I'm wrong, doesn't even seem like we even need to focus on this part of the platform right now, because...
You should not, yeah, because we're going to do this for you to make it simpler.
All right, and then what about on the... And on the feed... Yeah, I'm sorry, go ahead.
You get a customer that comes to you, wants a SIP trunk, has their own gateway, and wants 4 digits.
Yeah. I got you.
It's easier to do it here and load it in class 5 as 4 digits.
Yeah, and then...
But really, the only thing you're going to do right now is just manage your DIDs and then use this and manipulate the DIDs
here. Then I have to make sure that the DIDs are simultaneously in here and in the Phoenix office.
The interface, yes, you have to have them loaded here as us as a carrier.
Yep.
And then you manage them in the Phoenix stuff. So that's really all you need to do here.
Okay.
To deal with this. So in the Phoenix stuff interface, so Nathan, I created your account. I haven't created everybody else's account yet. We'll just go get yours. Where did I put it? Put it in here. This is actually a password. So I shrunk the interface down to kind of. Oops. I shrunk the interface down to if fewer screens.
Okay.
the crop you don't need to see, you don't need to see. So account maintenance is where you're going to spend the vast majority of your time.
Okay.
And you'll see your own category. That's sort of your partition. So TriStar.
Okay.
And if you search the partition, there's literally one thing in there right now, which is Tri ISP template. Okay. This is, now we can modify that before we start creating accounts. We should review the settings we have in here.
Yeah.
So it looks just like a normal account, and you just copy the template when you want to create a new customer.
Okay.
So some of the most important things that are going on is, I limited the maximum call to 180. Now these are in minutes, not in seconds, by the way, to 3 hours. You may want to up that. Right now the max duration we have set on our entire network is actually 3 hours because we found we only disconnect like 2 or 3 calls.
Let me ask you a question. If is there a notice that said after 3 hours that will tell the people, hey, your time is running up and it'll beep or something and let everyone know on the call?
As I understand it, yes, but I've never had a 3-hour-long call, so I've never heard it before.
Mm-hmm. So we could always always test a single number and just say 1 minute and see what happens. We could test it.
Yeah, yes. I mean, I've never tested it at 3 hours, but yeah, it's supposed to give you a message saying your call is now ending.
Okay.
And so max simultaneous call section, what is your standard per customer? Because this one is not a good number for this to be.
Well, as far as the standard,
like, you have to modify it based on the customer, but like, what do you want? These are the defaults. Do you want it to be 10 or 5 or 3 or 8?
Well, good question. Maybe one is not bad, just to start, because we're going to have to modify for each customer.
Yes, that's right.
So I'm just thinking out loud.
One is bad because if you forget to modify it, the customer is going to get really ticked off because after one call, their calls are going to stop working.
Okay, I gotcha. Harold, any input? You want to do 5 or 10? What are you thinking?
I do 10.
Let's do 10 as a standard template, okay. But we'll change it on each one.
So it will be 10. Let's see. Is that okay? So I put 1,000 calls per day max. That's probably also very high. And then max minutes per day, 500, because I think you're only doing 1,000 per.
We're doing 1,000.
Right.
Yeah, we're doing 1,000 per month per seat, but nobody uses that, you know. Although, wait a second. Although I take it back.
This is account wide. So you may want to. So you may want to do 1,000. Then that would be 30,000 a month.
Can I just
like do more per day and less per month?
Yeah, yeah. Also, I want to verify: is this all? This is all minutes, including just DID routing in and out.
In and out, yes.
In and out, okay. So, yeah, so we give them 1,000 minutes of long distance. But I don't know, you tell me, Eric.
So make this maybe 10,000 minutes per month or 20,000 minutes per month?
I don't know, you tell me.
It's really the reason you set this is because if there's fraud, you want to, this is a way of.
Yeah, I could download a list of usage from VoIP Innovations and it'll tell me. But let's just do whatever you think's best now, and we'll modify it later.
What's your average size customer? 10 seats, 20 seats?
Let's say 20 seats.
Okay, so 10,000 minutes is probably about where you want to be. And max minutes per day, you know, maybe leave it at 500.
Okay. We can always change the template in the future.
The customer. You can always modify the template.
Yeah.
You know, it's there. So I'd maybe leave it at this. I just like to use lowest possible numbers because then it, you know. So this is the template that you use. The credit is really actually, the credit really is just for, you know, is basically just for, you know, for fraud protection, essentially. So every call will actually get billed. And we also will auto, we have a system that will auto purchase and will notify you, like if it has to do an automatic renewal. But so DID calls don't get rated, like get rated as zero, will get rated as zero. Like the IDST calls will get rated, and the ID calls will get rated as zero. But, you know, if somebody's doing international,